Hello, guys, and welcome to Behind the Bunker here, episode 327 here, because, yeah, why would it be 200? 327 here at beautiful Kossuth Road Studios. My name is Todd Ansich. After a whole weekend of broadcasting live over the weekend for the Ontario Paintball League, we are exhausted and tired, but we are back, ready to service you guys tonight with a great show. So stay tuned, guys. Show starts in about 20 seconds.
Available on iTunes and anywhere you get your better podcasts. This is Behind the Bunker's weekly paintball podcast. Tonight's show is brought to you by Empire Paintball, Max Tact, Planet Eclipse, Modern Combat Sports, Tippmann and GI Sports, Air Ops Paintball Bunkers, Enola Gay Smoke Grenades, DLX, SP, and Gone. Flag Raiders Paintball. If you want to join the conversation, post your comments and we might read them on the show. Now let's get this nonsense started. Here's your host, Todd Ansich.
Awesome.
Yes. All right, guys, and welcome to Behind the Bunker. My name is Todd Ansich. Thank you very much for joining us here in our comfortable studio. Matt and I spent about 2 days, 17 hours, I think it is what we did over the long week, or over this weekend. We broadcast the Ontario Paintball League. As you can see, they bought me a fancy t-shirt. That's all I got from my weekend away. But we are back, so hopefully the studio is back set up and ready to go. It's nice to be somewhere comfortable. With me, I do not have Josh Zubizabrickus. I have some other schlep.
We bonjour.
Your dirty stash is not really doing very well.
It's the Walt Disney stash. And tonight, moi et Joe, on décide de parler français ce soir.
Je parle français un peu.
Si?
Oui.
Oui, oui.
Très bien.
Italian and French. And maybe Newfie. I don't know. We'll see.
So we also have Joe Kimson from Flaggers Paintball.
Hey, how are you? And welcome to beautiful Behind the Bunker. And it's a weekly live paintball TV show.
Is it?
Shoo. It's a really good shoo.
It's not a Seinfeld show.
This is microwave cookery, I thought.
Oh, then I'm in the wrong spot. I should be at home. It's garbage night.
You know what? I will not do microwave cookery anymore because there was one day I sent 30 of my best men to the latrines.
Because you're over salt and you over microwave.
I over seasoned. I got too cocky. Gavin Sharma from TerraTech Industries is with us.
I am here and I have some OXCC mojo. So,
ladies and gentlemen,
I'm happy you guys have tuned in. Make sure you hit like and share because this is a paintball podcast.
Put this on the end of your.
Do you know that is the end of our OXCC swag? We only have a couple more left, and then we are done.
Then I'm sticking one in my pocket, and we only have one left. So thank you so much for tuning in. Make sure you hit like and share. We've got a great paintball podcast coming up right now, so make sure you share the love.
We also have one last of these that we want to give away. Super Game Pass, 3-day admission.
Super Game, make sure you guys hit that.
And I was just messaged a little earlier tonight. We don't have it for today, but for next week's show, we definitely have something to give away that's pretty cool. So stay tuned for that. That'll happen shortly. Now, we also have in the production booth, Matt the Crypt, who is on camera tonight.
Yes, but I choose not to.
I spent 2 hours fixing that one.
I'm sure you did.
So lots to get to on the show tonight, guys. One last reminder. We're going to do one last roll call for this. Raza. Actually, we're going to do one more next week. But for now, if you guys would like one of these Behind the Bunker podcast hoodies.
I have mine here. I'll put it on later.
They are $79 US, and that includes the manufacturing and the delivery to your door. So if you guys want to do that, either direct message me or just shoot me a $79 US
or
PayPal.
Just shoot
to show at behindthebunker.com.
Just shoot Todd.
Shoot him.
Nothing crazy, but I want to show you guys this. This is Tippmann Sports Instagram. Why do I like this? Because it's a manufacturer that's on their Instagram page showing something other than a speedball player.
Yeah, it's
a granted it's still Tippmann, but it's still nice to see a recreational player being featured on a big company's social media feed.
Hooray for the little guy.
Exactly. Then this I saw as well. Bag of Chips, one of our regular viewers here. He says, watching paintball and playing Warcraft. Now, I don't like how Warcraft gets the bigger TV, but that's us, Matt. the mm-hmm. Ontario Paintball League.
Sure was.
This was sent in.
Ooh, pimp.
It said, wow. This is from Steve Birchfield. He says, I know you guys don't like evil guns, but this is a very special project for me. It's a better version of my old gun for the last 10 years. It shoots great even at 30 balls a second. This is the evil. Does anyone know what it is?
Pimp.
Evil. Oh, it's an evil. Yeah, Roger had one of those.
Yeah, pimp. Was board, die, hyper 3 reg, CP on off on it. Very cool. The one thing that they did was they designed that gun and then sort of gave up on the trigger. That's just
like
one
that
flat blade trigger. Getting... Really? You guys like that?
I did.
No. It's easier for walking.
I like the curvature of whatever. To each their own. And then he sends this picture in as well. He says, got my stickers. Now I have to decide where to put them. Very cool. He looks like he got his stickers from Eric Engler. Dan McClellan sent this in. Let me see if I can zoom out of this. Did you guys know that Ken Griffey Jr. has his own paintball gun?
Yeah, from Die, I saw it.
I did not know that.
I didn't know he was a paintball player.
Oh, you're not kidding.
Do you know that he has a 10 Gold Glove Award, 13 All-Star appearances? I have no idea.
And I bet just read the barrel. That's fine.
Pardon my ignorance, but it's baseball, right?
And that's got to know that board.
I don't follow baseball, but I mean, good for him for having that. Well, Seb, are you going to buy one of these?
Hold that board. Hold it. That's the only thing I can say. Hold that board.
Hold that.
He had an ego there in like 06.
Did he?
Yeah.
All I have to say is if he's getting any paint or baseball players into paintball, because baseball is far huger of a, or huger, far bigger of a, wow. a viewership than we, then good for us. But cool. Hmm. But what's even more cool.
Super game, super game, super game, super game, East.
That's coming up in just a couple of weeks. Make sure you guys get signed up. And if you want to register for that and you don't win a pass from us, make sure you guys put BTB10 in their promo code and buy online. You get 10% off. So don't miss out on that. Seb, you sent in a couple of pictures. Can I show them?
Absolutely.
Can you explain yourself?
Yeah, this is Gov Silence Champion. This is a team that practices quite a bit. In the sense I've been very sarcastic right yeah. now. So the guy on the far right and the guy dead center is Ian McComb, and the guy on the far right is our good friend Eric Richards. In a lot of ways, they were my mentors, much like you, Todd, at some point.
I thought you were my protege.
Well, I don't know.
The protege mentor relationship
America,
is a.
I was, but here I'm not sure.
Have you written them a proposal on or a report on risk management?
Well, it was the Penske file just keeps me so busy.
But these guys are great, as you said. They use the event as practice.
Bless their hearts. They're good people. They've done a lot to the speedball paintball around here. Actually, can you go back to the spectacular picture of Eric sliding
doing
like a champ?
Knee slide?
It's such a hipster pose, too, by the way, Eric, if you're watching this. There's no way he's watching this, yeah. But hey.
And then what's with the gun?
Well, this was sent by someone that really likes Soledad Board, like, much like me, with a Habs hockey team jersey in the back.
Habitons.
So, there's the Rocket jersey and the Die M2 with fancy schmancy OLED
stuff.
Board.
Yeah. That's why you, that's why you sent it in, because it's an OLED.
And that thing shoots rope, yo.
rope, yo.
So, lots on the show tonight. We're going to have Custom Corner. Joe will have that up shortly. We might even have Paintball Around the World without Zuby in. Maybe Gavin might do that. I think he's got the sheets in front of him. But before we do that, let's get to our weekly segment. Is the mail here?
Let me check the box for the mail. No, the postman is here, so let me rip open the sack.
That one email I sent you, don't read.
All right. Yeah. Excellent. Perfect.
The one about our financial ruins.
Yes.
And how we're not making any money and we're going to shut off our cable.
All right. So stay tuned for the next at least...
Go ahead.
30 minutes or so, because the cable bill is paid up until then. So the first question comes to us from Tyrell Owens. Tyrell T-Bone! he wants to know.
Why no T-Bone?
Question for the show. In what currency is the quarter that the paintball uses to measure the size of the paint mark on the player? Does that depend? Does that change depending on the country? Or is there an international standard? I think I know the answer, but I want to know your thoughts.
It's the North American version. Canadian and American quarters are very similar in size, are they not, Gavin?
They are. They're similar, but they're not identical because you can't use them in soda machines.
You cannot use them in soda machines, and then the Canadian quarters used to be made out of silver until 1967 or 1980. Now it's made primarily out of nickel, and the Americans are nickel and copper.
So to answer your question, quarter size is regional.
Yeah. Hey, I want to, agree with Greg Beck here for a second. He says, don't worry, this will become a train wreck.
Yes, yep.
I'm sure it will.
You know
shortly.
What you're getting into.
Yeah. It's a chapeau evening. You know when you go to some games and it's a hat night and they give everybody a hat? Well, that's the same thing that happens here in the production booth today. So.
Yeah.
Chapeau. But Joe wins.
All right. So next question comes to us from James Ben Stent. And he wants to know, who's the best player in any league of any country?
Arguably, people would say, what's his name? Lang, years ago.
No, but I don't think that he's holds true. He's on his vision quest.
He is on
retired.
His vision quest. did that start while he was at that Indian casino?
The Guatemalan identity pepper.
Yes. So that's a good question. Seb, you're more of a speedball guy than some of these other guys. What do you guys think? Best player active right now? I know it's argumentative.
Okay, so this is all, personal opinion in terms of both his skill level and what he's done for the sport and his leadership abilities and awesome Instagram pics and videos. Ryan Greenspan.
Yeah.
Ryan Greenspan.
Yeah.
Dynasty crew, the core crew who have still played since they were like 17-year-old or 16-year-old kids before that with Spider Cup. Greenspan, he still grinds away and he's still like incredible player
the
and
Iron
mentor.
Kids. The Iron Kids players.
He's
an original gangster.
So I'm still saying, there's some young up and comers and some older school players as well. But I'm saying Ryan Greenspan has my
John Holmes was an up and comer.
He's got the key to my heart. I still have his poster on my wall.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Buddy.
Anybody else? Or is that
Mr. Monville deserves a nomination here.
So much so that you couldn't remember who he was last time.
Yes, that was sure. I agree.
And I'm going to have to go with my main man in France here and say Alex Godin. He's at least for the Europeans.
Yeah.
That little guy just moving all over the field.
There's a ton of players. I mean, Infamous has a couple of good, but Russians, I mean, there's so many good players. You mentioned Greenspan. Another guy that no one really talks about is Rao, Josh Rao.
Oh, you're not kidding.
Yosh
Rao. No, it's Josh. I call him Josh.
But those are the Dynasty Core people, right, who've been playing together for decades now, right?
And then there's some new up-and-comers. Like, there's lots of... that's a hard question.
Kyle Hickey in the chat forum says,
I know who
Bobby
sucks.
Dukes. Bobby Dukes.
I was just going to say, I know who sucks. Yeah. Oh, well. It'd be nice if people could know who some of the better scenario players were. Do you know what I mean? Like, and I'm not talking like social media represented, scenario players. I'm talking about like guys that play all the time and have been a while, like some of the old Master Blasters,
So I'm going to stomp you on that in the same train of thought. We're not derailing. This comes from 86FRS. Can events like Iron City Classic save paintball? That was some incredible coverage. Our friend Simon from Inception Designs, I was following a lot of his old school people that I really looked up to when I first got into the sport, playing again on some woods ball fields.
Hyperball, wasn't it?
Hyperball and like some of the hill terrain play. It was like old school paintball brought to 2017. It was absolutely incredible to watch. So can that save paintball?
Did you watch some of that?
I did watch some of that, yes.
Was it my imagination or did I see some guys wearing a Team Image jersey?
Yes, it is.
You're not kidding. Yeah, yeah,
there's no imagination. We're talking like, all the old school teams.
Oh. Do you remember the old school Joy Division team from England, I think they were from?
Sweden.
Sweden.
Same place as the Volvo.
MacDev, not MacDev.
Angels.
Angels.
Yeah. Yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
Man.
So,
but I'm glad
can that save paintball? Yeah, I think it's not, it's certainly not going to hurt. It's going to introduce those newer players that have just jumped into the sport to how paintball grew and how it established tournament play. And some real legends were out there shooting some old school some markers. Simon, tip of the hat to you. I know I saw Mike Paxson shooting a Predator Conquer. So, you know, that gets me excited about the sport again, watching some of the legends playing and still mixing it up and doing well.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, anything for paintball is good. And I hate to be the guy, but we got to stop stereotyping genres of paintballs and any form of paintball, whether they're...
We're all in the same boat, folks.
We are. Why? What's funny about that?
We pluralized paintball.
Paintballs.
Paintballs.
I know. I've been around Seb too long, and we've been up with the French for the last 2 days.
Je parle français pour le reste du podcast.
Joe.
Yeah.
Seb.
So I don't know. I mean, any paintball event really is going to... Anything that can bring people in. And I like tournaments. I like events that cater to younger people or people that are new to the sport. You know, like Paint Fest, when you're giving away free entries and free rentals just to bring stuff in. That's cool. That's
well,
cool.
I think anything right now with social media, Facebook Live, paintball can be much more accessible than it ever has been. And so I think people that have been playing originally who didn't quite have the same coverage other than APG or Tag or Paintball Games International print version, bringing it in your face, in your social media devices, whether that's in your smartphone as you're walking around grocery shopping, that helps the sport as people like and share, just like this program now, like and share, and making it accessible to people who may not have even played this sport before. I think that's only going to help grow the sport.
Yeah, for sure. Someone just mentioned Greg Hastings. He would be a good contender for one of the better scenario players just because he did start in speedball. He's had a long time of, playing. You know, be pretty good. I would enjoy playing with him more if he showered and washed his gear more, but, he is what he is.
He's an imbastard, damn it.
He's a bastard? What?
And I can't tell you who gets the microphone awards tonight already, because Todd just did something great and got rid of a really disgusting hiss.
That was me.
Right,
I was just humming.
Was that you meditating again?
Okay,
but how fair is that? Who else has controls of the buttons other than Matt the Creep?
Yeah.
Yep.
And Todd.
Yeah.
See what I did there, Chef?
Todd Gack.
Yeah.
I don't like being associated with him. More questions?
No, I'm going to cinch up my sack because you freeloaders didn't do a whole lot for us in sending in correspondence. But if you would like a question addressed on the show, send it to show@behindthebunker.com. Post below in the chat form or send it into Instagrams, Twitter, or any other form of social media. And we will open up the sack and let you guys know what our thoughts are on your questions.
Mind you, two more pages just came in hot off the press.
The postman is working late this evening, so...
Non-unionized employees.
I'm sorry. Those came in over there.
All right.
Can I ask, though, there is a question that's coming in on the chat. Should we read that? I'm just seeing a question. Is it worth reading?
Sure. Well, why don't you go ahead, Todd?
Question to Todd and the crew. Have you guys given any thoughts to attending more pop culture cons to create the sport and do what you guys did with Greg in Texas for the game launch? Joe and I would do it, but the thing is, our agent has told us to hold out for a little bit more.
Your Asian?
Our Asian has told us to wait and, get more upgrades before we go down there. No, we would do that in a second. If Greg organizes something like that again, we would. I know the guys at... I know the name escapes me, but there's another one that's being so there's something similar being done like that as well. Band of Brothers, god damn, I don't know how I forgot that. Band of Brothers is doing something at an airfield as well, and I'm so tired I don't have the details. I know Josh has all of it, he's not in tonight, but they're doing something there that's a paintball related thing at a place that has nothing to do with paintball, and they're going to try to get more players in. So things like that is what this industry needs for sure.
All right, Sorry. So next question comes to us from young Nikki Slowiak, young player who wants to make a break into the
Nicholas
scene.
That's the guy we could add to that list of three old players.
Well, he has a question for you. You know what? I will throw this to you, Seb.
Sure.
Because young Nikki Slowiak wants to know, who puts the bump in the bump shoo wop shoo wop?
Well, that's an easy answer. Garvin Sharma does.
Well, John Jones would disagree with you, and he says, who puts the ram in the ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong?
Well, that'd be Joe with the fancy right. Lux hat tonight.
So, legitimate goal. Thank you so much, Nick. We will send you some stickers and our email or our mailed correspondence.
But you didn't read my response to that. Is it in there?
Have you heard Bird is the Word? I didn't want to go there. It's your show, so I'm going to have to say it. But so next question comes was from
Servant Bird.
Bradley Belsky. He wants to know, great question, is MagFed replacing pump, at least around the Michigan area, and a number of areas?
Are you still live, Matt?
Nope, wait. The stream is dropping.
Struggling.
Oh, well, let's
We're
keep recording.
Some electrical.
Some serious.
Yeah, we had some lightning touchdown, and we had some.
Is it lightning?
I don't know, but
sure
our powers just went down.
Was
so
it lightning?
It was lightning.
How do you know?
You should get rid of that too, there, Matt. If
it's
you
a
can.
Tropical storm. Seb came from all the right. Mediterranean, from
good?
The beaches like of Nice.
Yes, I'm not sure.
I'll try a different output.
Has anyone seen this?
That's what she said. I'll try a different output.
Well, let's keep recording because we are still going anyway. So.
All right. So sorry, folks. So the next question comes to us from Brian Belsky and wants to know, is MagFed replacing pump? At least around Michigan, most limited ammo events have turned into MagFed-only games. Still loves playing pump in open days, but not much going on for the pump scene.
I would say there's more MagFed in our neck of the woods than there is pumps.
And it seems not only to be regional, I think it seems to be global. That there's much more a stronger movement for MagFed-only games and no accommodation or adaptation of that, right? So we're not even talking limited ammo, we're talking purely MagFed. So I know within the province of Ontario and in California as well, MagFed continues to grow. They have regular scenario games or big games that are exclusively MagFed. So question is, MagFed, yes, it is growing. It is it's a huge market that continues to grow. Is that going to replace pump? I don't think so. I think pump is always going to be around. Stock class. I think
should both coexist anyways, right?
We should use the word.
For sure.
We're all paying
genre. Todd hasn't used the word genre today.
Is it, but I don't think, will it replace pump? Absolutely not. But I think right now the flavor of the month happens to be MagFed. And I think that's where the most producers are investing money into their big games. But pump will never go away. That sort of started paintball. You're still going to have those limited ammo where pump is available. But I think right now this is the flavor of the month, flavor of the year. MagFed continues to grow.
Now, what would Zuby say about this question, you think, Todd?
He would say, have your local airsoft spayed and neutered is what he would say.
I'm glad that, you know, a lot of people have adopted the MagFed, and that's awesome because the sport is growing. But the pump players, those that play it, I think very few of them are going to leave their genre
Gavin?
To go into something else. There's definitely a playing style and a love for that handicap by having that pump.
I think Joe has a question.
I have a point. Gavin, you said what started it all was pump. Actually, the original paintball gun was the Nelspot 007, and if I recall, which I do, it was bolt action.
That's still
so maybe,
pump, really. You gotta cock it back and slide it forward, right? That's the.
You know, that's more of a. It's more lock and load, like a sniper
well, it's
rifle.
It's bolt action, right? So pump was to replace some of the limitations of the technology, right? So that became.
Oh, I concur. Limitations of the technology. I love that. What a buzzword. That blows genre out of the water.
Technological limitations.
Technological limitations.
And that's why constant feed. You know, there were oil cans that went in first before they were proprietary, or not even proprietary, manufactured hoppers,
yes.
Right? Before the hopper system, right? Stick feeds and all sorts of crazy things.
Different things.
Bulk load, so... So, Bradley, thank you for your question. We're about to fight soon, but...
No, we won't fight. No? I concur.
No, that was a great discussion, actually.
Technological limitations. They said that at BlackBerry, too, when Owl came out with the iPhone 6.
So how about this? Like, everybody talks about, like, who's growing the sport in this, but I think at some point we need to discuss how technology advances paintball, too. Whether it's on a scenario marker, or on a speedball marker, on a entry-level marker, it doesn't really matter.
On the goggles?
On the, yeah, I mean the eyes. I'm still waiting for the eyes goggle system.
Might be waiting a while.
Yeah. Well, so my deck kept never wrong, so.
There seems to be a slowdown in terms of innovative products.
We've definitely plateaued.
We're back live now, so the guys on Facebook are seeing it, and they're already making comments that asking if we did actually pay our internet bill. I should not have said it at the beginning of the show, and now I'm knocking on wood.
You too can buy a support package but to help get us on live the whole time.
I can't. Okay. Yeah, our podcast listeners, this is seamless for them. Seamless as best as seamless as the show is going to be. It's still going to be a train wreck. But for you that are watching at home, we're now live again. You should be able to see us now. Yeah.
Sean Riddle texted me and he said the power went out at the world's smallest indoor as well.
So they lost their patrons.
They lost their power.
And there's some Germans peeing right now.
Yeah. For those of you that are coming back, make sure you hit that like and share button, guys, so people can know what's going on.
We're all okay, by the way.
Yes, okay. we are fine. Don't worry about us.
So when you listen back to the podcast, we had a quasi-lively as we tried to replace the technological limitations of our internet regarding MagFed replacing pump, and we say no.
Matthew Stone in the chat has the best comment so far tonight. Episode 324.5.
That was brilliant.
Yeah, as you can see, our monitor in front of us, we lost power to everything. The only thing that survived was our battery backups, thankfully, so we're okay. Cool. Do you have more questions from that, I'm hoping?
You can hope away.
Do, 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 do. Such a catchy song, eh?
It is.
I blame Todd Gack for that.
I don't have our sponsors on here, but for now I'm just going to put Greg Hastings Tournament Paintball on the monitor so you have something to watch.
Hi, Greg. All right. Perfect. Next question comes to us from Aaron McCombs, and he wants to know, would you ever consider having a fan of the show guest host with you over Skype or the phone line?
We've done that, and we've had really good success, but then we've had times where it's been painful.
Somebody kept hanging up on people.
Yeah. Here's what we're going to do later on in the program. We might actually take a couple of your calls, and that'll be your chance. What we do is we call them blind calls, but really they're auditions for new cast members. We're trying to get rid of one of our cast members, but we're not saying who.
It's okay. You can get rid of me. I'm fine.
He doesn't get the hint when we lock the studio door. But yeah, so we might take a couple of your phone calls later on. And to be honest with you, sometimes we get on a roll and it's hard to get you guys on, so it's hard. We also
sometimes
find
that it's hard to get you off.
Not Seb. The
I'm concerned about our friend Brent here. I'm wondering if Brent's in the chat tonight.
Brent Davis is in the chat.
I'm saying, Brent, are you here, sir? Maybe I should type in French too for him or something. I don't know.
All right. Next question comes to us. Our last question for Matthew Stone. Did Joe ever follow up and find out the actual UV ratings on different lenses from different manufacturers? All right. 42.
I have no idea. Still do we curious. Know about UV?
We don't know. We're waiting for some comments.
Okay.
All right, so Matthew, stand by, my friend. We have not forgotten about you. We're waiting for correspondence back. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for hanging in with us for this evening's mail time segment. And if you have any other correspondence, shoot it in the chat form below, and we'll see if we can get time to get to it.
Or into a napkin. So, sorry, Gavin, I just killed you there.
Sure did, but it's your show.
Yeah, that's how tired I am. So why don't we move on, guys? We have Custom Corner to get to. We also have Paintball Around the World. But by this point, Gavin's already pissed off at me. So let's go over to Joe then, and let's do some Custom Corner, Matt.
Hey guys and girls, welcome to Custom Corner, where you, the viewer, send anything you modified, customized, or tricked out in your paintball arsenal. And I changed my hat to a customized, modified, tricked out hat.
You have the same as Gavin, though.
I am wearing the same
Tipperman
hat.
We can't see you, Joe.
But I'm going to stop you for a second, Joe. Why this is faded and why I will never get rid of this. I won this in the TIPX shootout. Do you recall that?
I remember vividly.
That was like 30 years ago.
That's right. You know what? I'm still rocking this full mojo, and I wore it this evening simply because I want to win Price is Right. So,
nice.
We'll see.
Whoa. Hey, speaking of baseball caps or hats and stuff, I found a 100th Monkey bounce cap. And I know you were asking about one a while ago. If you, if I find it again, is it something that you or your daughter still require? Or
so I have. My daughter has one. I have a ripped up one. What color is it?
What are you looking for?
Black.
It also comes with a cummerbund.
Black tuxedo. Black tuxedo. Black, black, black.
Black.
Black tuxedo.
Okay.
All right.
It's no longer your segment, Kevin. So first custom corner, Joe, I have this. Number, yep, there we go.
There we go. This comes to us from somebody on June 24th. I'm not, oh, James. James Woodhams. There we go.
Very cool.
This is his modified, customized. It's Ego.
Whoa.
Shadow Warrior.
Oh, that bar. Everybody's skipping over the...
Uh-oh. And Steve Dallas. This
do we
is
take
my
a blind call?
Reb Line MLL with a six-pack CO2 quick change. Very rare.
That's not a tracer, is it?
No, it's a Reb Line mill with a six-pack.
That looks like something like the SS with a
That predates like your Bushmaster, wow. Line SI and stuff like that around the same era.
But the six-pack is so damn sexy.
Six-pack is awesome.
Yeah. Very cool. I think we have someone on the phone. Did we answer that?
I did. We didn't answer the phone.
Hello?
Hello?
Wow. Wow.
Whoever that is, okay, I'm going to fill you guys in. Whoever that is, he's done that like three times now, where he's just called in, cleared his throat, and then hung up on us. I don't know if it's Simon Stevens honing the point that you're never going to hang up on him again or who it is, but very nice. All right, let's get back to Custom Corner. That
yes,
was a nice six-pack, just like when I lift my shirt.
This comes to us from Brandon Curley. This is his DSP V2. Maybe a dangerous? What is that?
I don't know.
Duck slide. Something.
It's a pump.
Wow,
it is pump.
For nice. Matt the Crypt not to know, I'm my head is spinning. Right
I
now.
Like the Navajo print Code Talker blanket behind it.
But does Navajo really go with wicker?
It does.
It's like Caribbean meets
what?
Something
Native
it's
American
like cool pillow too, though. Like everybody's missing.
And this one comes to us from Will Roberts, and all three are custom guns.
Wow, look at that!
Look at that!
All with OLED boards.
All with a chair.
Very good. Yeah.
Antifreeze.
Felix Garcia, ooh. Custom Hammer 7. Look at that.
I wouldn't have told you that was a Hammer 7 if you didn't tell me.
That is
that's
pretty nice. That's looks like a Magpul stock, I think.
And a custom Muskoka chair.
It's custom Muskoka chair. And Miguel Angel, Mickey Bernard, Bernabe sends us this gem, First Strike.
Very nice.
Modified, look at that. It's pretty nice. And Tyrell Peffler. It may or may not be a paintball Nerf rifle. Who knows?
It's a Vortex. It's a Tippmann Model 98 with a Vortex kit from MCS. I can see the word Vortex right there.
Pretty crazy.
Nicely done.
Good eyes for an old timer.
Good eyes.
Who said that?
Seb. And Andrew Teves. Pure CS1 with matching Boomy CSR trigger white grips and soon to be custom anode.
You know?
Andrew Teves is actually vacationing right now in the small coastal community of Portugal.
Wow.
And if you look at here, he has his concert bracelet from Lady Gaga.
He's also nice. Got an OLED board. I'm
he's
so
got
proud
an OLED.
Of, I'm so proud of all the OLED owners out there right now.
Oh, look at this.
And
one.
Nolan Sweatikoff, a box mag.
Wow.
Fed with an EMR5 inside.
That's awesome.
That's beautiful.
So when he comes up to the counter and says, I would like some more bullets.
For my box mag.
That's awesome.
That's very
well done.
Nicely done.
It looks like
Mike Kennedy.
Whoa.
My old Ham H7 Dam Magwell handguard milled out 1.5 aluminum bar stock and aluminum charging handle. That's
that
pretty
light.
Nice.
That looks so light, too.
So
well done.
Wow. Good job.
That's why we call it Custom Corner.
And whoa. This guy is scratched out. This one comes to us from Patrick Baker. That is a magnificent mag-fed shooter.
Cool.
Look at
there.
That. Do you like that?
I
like
I did
it too.
Like that.
I like very nice. Oh, Damon Cornish sends us that. What is it?
It's a
Hammer 7 again.
Or is it a tracer? No.
Do you know what? I need to go on eBay right now and buy every Hammer 7 I can possibly buy because
buy
it is
any.
The hardest. It is the most customized gun. I would say if someone asked me a question up to a year ago and said, what is the most customized gun on the market, I would have said Ion. No, I would have said Ion. Because how many guys put ions inside of Nerf guns, inside of other sort of stuff?
Or an now ion, would say the Hammer 7.
You'd see them in stores or shelves, and dudes just sit there collecting dust.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
But it's the epiphany. Holy moly.
Speaking of epiphany, this is Tiffany's gun.
Nice segue that you guys did. Yeah.
This is Tiffany Benoit. It's a French name.
Oh, that's from Bonjour.
And can we stop for a second? What Seb just actually said was actually quite intelligent. I forgot that the it's a surprise. First of all, let's finally. I forgot that there was an epiphany that was the high end version of the Ion. Yeah. I forgot all about that.
The epiphany.
It was a beautiful marker.
Yeah,
it was. As you'd like.
Sorry, I just didn't want to stop.
No,
that's one of those trivia. That's one of those trivia questions I could have asked you guys.
Derek Murphy.
I said that's one of those trivia questions I could have asked.
Derek Murphy sends us a Q gun air gun, Q loaded air gun.
No OLED board.
No.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Why the hell would you put a Q loader on an air bow? I love the air bow. I get you wrong, but there's no way you're going
to
outshoot a Q loader.
Why do you need?
But I guess it acts as a hopper as well, right? So
it's got everything you need to make it. Because most of the air bows are stick fed, so this would give you more paint balls.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
This one is not first strike compatible.
So with that, you can shoot 4 rounds a second, too.
That's right. This is
That's beautiful.
This is Tommy.
Oh, mama.
A. Akron.
Again, so that's all the OLED community people got coming out of the woodwork.
Very nice.
Seb is also starting a Facebook page called OLED Lovers Unite. So you guys should head on over and join it.
Send pictures of your carpet, your cats, and your gat with OLED boards.
I totally make sure you type that correctly.
Yes, watch carpet and cats. Yes. Don't
watch those keystrokes.
Yeah.
This comes to us from Mickey Bergman. Little pistol spider tracer. Is that what it is, or is it a? And then
I'm waiting for Matt.
Would say that's not his paintball. That's either real steel or airsoft.
I know, that's cool.
So that it ready.
Regardless, very nice to see. All right, let's see. What do we have here?
Tyrell Paffer going for the distance. Ha ha. So this is like a sniper rifle, I think.
We just saw that a few minutes ago from a different angle.
On a different, looks like on a control panel of
it. It is. Like it is. It's the Nintendo.
Whatever the game, the Nintendo, whatever the...
Is that a table or is that just a...
I don't know.
It's a cloth or
it's the
something.
Same one for Skate or Die.
Ooh, look at that.
Yeah, the coverts don't match the drapes.
Well, you get that.
You're a jerk.
Tyrell,
this poor guy takes time of his day to send this picture of his nice-looking marker.
Grandma, this is what he gets.
Let me apologize.
This one comes to us from Dylan Churchill. This is his drum-fed A5. It's a Phenom, isn't it?
Yeah. Maybe.
Nicely done.
It's a Fiat.
Dylan also has a Max loader as well.
Now, Joe, that should be the end of your printed sheets.
It
although
is.
Little Joey Kimpson sent in this today.
Yeah, this came today. One of the camp kids. We do a paintball day camp at Flaggers, and one of the camp kids sent this in. It's a long distance rubber knife fighting. It's got a drop forward on it, so you can handle it.
This
vertical
is
grip. Yeah, it's very nicely
it's
done.
Totally
so
brilliant.
Anyway, that comes to us from Little Jacob Lynchich.
And then I gave you a couple of sheets, too,
today,
earlier this evening, in reference to...
Let me see.
This bad boy, or these bad boys.
Hang on.
Oh, what do we have here?
More pimps.
Twice
more
the evil.
Pimps.
I don't see them, Todd.
Yeah, I gave it to you just before the show.
Detonator reg.
It's on eBay now. We'll let Matt describe this with his sultry voice. Go ahead, Matt. You have faith.
Detonator reg.
Now the guy is complaining that we're bastardizing his pictures.
This is the gentleman that I showed at the top of the hour with the pimp. So I forget his name. I had crumpled up the piece of paper already. And then this comes. And we're really butchering this. I'll have to find that sheet again.
Harbach.
But
factory team.
Yeah, this is back in the day when he did some custom specials and signed off on that as well.
I love that jersey too. Seriously.
Duracell.
I still probably have my evil yellow jersey somewhere.
Yeah. I would love to hug you in it, Todd, to be honest.
I'm going to... One sec. Let's try this. And I apologize. Hello. Who's on the air?
Hello.
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 Bingo.
Bingo.
Bingo on the show.
Beyond G.I. Joe.
Give us a name, sir. Who
it's
are
Reaper.
You? Or, is it?
My name is Jim Jeffrey, and I think I believe I won the bingo. I'm calling in.
B-I-N-G-O.
I believe it's a crank caller. There we go. We're going to get rid of that. Goodbye.
I don't blame him for doing that to us, honestly.
It's my own fault for taking blind calls right now.
I swear it was Reaper. I swear.
All right. If you're going to call in, by the way, don't call from an anonymous number because, quite honestly, I'm not going to take it. At least if you crank call me from your home number. I'm not going to call you back and say, why'd you do that?
Actually, he will at 2 in the morning.
Stop 2 in the morning. Yeah, exactly. Guy. All right. So here it is, guys. We have, we were just talking about eBay. What about doing some Prices Right? You guys in the mood for some Prices Right tonight?
Sure. Absolutely. Am, Skip.
I had Prices Right.
People in the chat room saying that I would have already hung up on that guy long ago. Bless your heart, sir.
Otis in the chat says, is your refrigerator running? Yes, it's about that. All right, let's start off something easy. One sec, Matt, that's not it.
Let me just. I have to make a
oh, I got
Joe's
ready,
opening
Joe.
His Lotus 1-2-3 right now.
I have to make a.
He's creating a spreadsheet. Here we go. Here, 68 Automag Classic Paintball Gun.
Signed by.
But there's nothing special about that other than the fact that it's signed by Bob Guernsey.
Oh.
Oh.
Look at that trigger.
Mm-hmm.
Is there it's very comfortable. A certificate of authenticity? Like, is there
it
any
does
way
not
you can
say,
know?
And I almost think that signature looks like Guernsey. Or Gorenzi.
The guy that did the podcast with OPL with last weekend?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yep. All right. Bob Guernsey, signed Automag. Who won last week? Did anybody?
Oh, wait. Hold on.
Zuby.
You kept it. Good for you. Finally.
No, I think it was a
Zuby
tie.
Won. He got 3.
Yeah. So, Zuby, you get to go tonight. Slightly less facial hair.
Oh. $22.22
Sorry, $2,200 or
oh, $22 okay. And 22 cents.
Steve Birchfield saying $350, Bob, and Donnie McFarlane saying $375. What about the blind call on the line? What are you saying for this custom autographed gun? Hello, that's you. That phone called.
They're not saying anything. Hang up.
They
hang
use
up.
Their dialing wand. All right, beat so it. Gavin, what are you thinking?
Damn. Papa Paintball signed it, so I'm going to say $600, Bob.
$600. I'm seeing Chad Bateman saying $150. Jimmy Churchill saying $175.01. What are you saying, Joe?
$325.
This sold for $175. Isn't that a shame?
No. So booyah. Sad.
I'm representing Zuby in the house tonight.
Represent.
Boys.
Lowballing.
All right, so here's what I'm thinking, guys. If you want to start your own professional paintball
Holy
team,
moly.
This is what you guys need. It is a listing for 10 used Tippmann 98 paintball guns. Wow. No longer will your teammates have gun issues while they're on the field.
No. In the cold, are
they
heat?
Nor will they be getting called no for overshooting.
No problem.
Here we go, guys. 10 used Tippmann Custom 98s. I know what I'd pay for them, but what would you pay for them, Seb?
I would pay $300, Bob.
Okay. Joe, what are you thinking?
$180.
Blake, the man, says $100. Brandon says axe plus cash.
Somebody said they'll survive a nuclear war.
Donnie McFarlane's a little closer to what I thought, maybe $417. $600 from Kathy. There's a girl watching. Brent Ooh. Davis, I don't know, Brent. I don't know what your nationality or your background is, but you always come in with the chintziest bet. He says $100, Bob. Do you think $100 for 10 Tippmanns is worth it? What do you guys think? Do we have all your bids in?
No, we're waiting on no. Gavin.
$250, Bob.
Okay.
25 each.
Joe?
Joe's bid, $180.
Okay. Well, these sold for $500.
Wow.
Whoa.
William Bailey says a jug of moonshine. What would be a jug of moonshine? The value of a jug of moonshine.
Yeah, I'm on bleep and fire tonight. Just saying.
You know what? Okay, so you guys have won your 10-man event because there you go right now. And Here we go. Now you want to upgrade markers?
Oh, come on.
What's for Raptors, are they not?
11 used twin turbo, or sorry, twin tube blowback paintball guns. And they have barrel plugs in them ready to go.
I think these were left in the trunk of a convertible LeBaron.
They say they work. And this is from a place called Mariana's Emporium. If you're going to buy anything from an emporium,
it better be Mariana's.
Yeah.
The organ emporium? The Texan. No.
Yeah, I lost my overhead, didn't I, Matt?
Your overhead?
Yeah.
Yes, you did.
Okay, so what are you guys thinking on this? Seb, I need a bid.
I will go with $222, Bob.
Wow, getting crazy.
All right.
What?
Joe, what are you thinking?
180.
Gavin.
200.
The actual selling price of this was $200.
Wow.
Does he? You should almost get a bonus point.
I know. You reach into your pocket, grab $100.
Absolutely. Who do we have on the line right now? We're going to take one.
Hi, this is Vince calling from Tony's Pizza. Your pizza is out for delivery, but we're having problems with your credit card.
Well, you're going to have problems with your credit cards. Do you accept kidneys?
Okay, well, somebody placed an order 20 minutes ago.
Yes, sir.
Three medium cheese pizzas. They're coming for delivery. They're up right now.
Very good. I will send my bottles in for deposit.
Well,
maybe somebody
else in the house order it. I don't know.
I know this is from the prank call website.
Pizza's got to be paid for.
Right now. We're being pranked.
Thanks for the call, sir.
From the prank owl website. Come on, guys. At least if you're going to prank call us, be a man.
Do it yourself, damn it.
Do it yourself. Don't use the prank
owl
website.
I know you guys are thinking it's cringy, but I enjoy taking some of these phone calls to see if they have any ammunition to do anything here. Okay, so you guys started a paintball team and you had 10 Tippmans, and now you had these 11 blowback guns that none of them worked. So now you lost all your players, but you still have three and you want to play a three event. Let's do this. Paintball gun lot, assortment of three guns for the price of one. I see an Impulse, Smart Parts Impulse. I see a JT 3.0.
And I see an autococker. Nice 2K4 autococker.
With a brilliant matching green flame drop forward for the win. But who gets the eggy? That's the thing. They all shoot super fast. But who's going to get the egg?
I think, who had the last one? I think
Gavin.
Gavin,
don't even take time to think about it because you're on fire. What are you thinking?
250, baby.
250. All right. Joe, what are you thinking?
Oh, I don't know. 275.
Dan McClellan says $723 plus I think he's on crack. Tom Jennings says $200 just for the egg, and I agree. Kathy, she's a girl, says $400, Bob.
What William, $230. Shane, $300. Cecil, $300. Brent. You know what? I've got to go with my main man, Brent Davis, here.
But
$325.
Okay, but you got to go back to Cecil. Cecil says $300 flat.
Cecil, flat.
Meaning he will not change his bid. That's
no,
it. You're not getting him for more than $300 flat. All right. That's almost as bad as saying, how much will you take taxes out the door?
Oh, I remember that guy.
All right. Does anybody want to change the
bid?
What
did Seb say?
I said the same as Brent. $325, yeah.
Okay. This sold for $174.99. I think you all overbid.
Yeah,
didn't
we all overbid.
We all did.
Okay, you know what? Here's a chance for you guys to get back on the board. And, you know, you mentioned this a little while ago, so I'm glad that you're doing this. I'm going to ignore this one for just a second here. So, Paintball Spider Cup 2000, presented by Kingman, VHS tape.
Man,
look at that.
That's tough.
It's like 17 years old.
Has been opened, has been watched, but it's in very good condition.
Don't tell me the outcome.
Are we going back to Gavin for this one? We are. Gavin, what would you pay for this?
First, I have to purchase a VCR player again. And
it'd be worth it.
$20, Bob.
Okay. Joe, what are you thinking? I'm seeing $12 from Shizzle Manizzle.
$11.
Kathy says $5.99. Lee Cuddle says, who still has a VHS?
I do.
Attaboy. Tracy Byrne says $20. And Lisa says a bag of Cool Ranch chips.
Whoa.
What are you thinking, Joe?
$11.
$11. All right. Seb?
Let's go with, I don't think it's sold for the record, but I'm going to say $5.
$5. All right. It did sell. and it sold for $13.
Overbid again.
Joe gets it. He's on the board.
Joe. Très bien.
All right. Let's take one more call. Let's see what happens to this one. You're on the air, sir. Or ma'am. Hello?
It's painful.
Very.
Yeah, I would have hung up by now, Todd.
Yeah, like, I just did. All right. So here we go.
Program, buddy.
Stunning paintball wall art and paint decor.
Whoa.
This is a 36 by 48 inch print.
That looks awesome.
I gotta ship it, man.
That couch is like behind a bunker special edition couch too.
Shipping is a non-issue at this point. Let's not worry about shipping. So what would you guys pay for something like this? I'm seeing Logan Fisher saying $250 and Thomas saying $180. See, the sad thing is if you went to IKEA, that'd be like a $40 print.
And you'd get meatballs too.
And there'd be like 100 of them in a rack.
And a hot dog. Yeah. In a rack. Me up.
All right.
$300, Bob.
$300, Bob.
Well, yeah. All right.
Greg Beck says $74.99, Bobbo.
Bobbo.
I don't know if I like that. Joe, what are you thinking?
Your rating?
$125.
Seb?
$75.
Does anybody want to change the bid?
Gavin hasn't bid.
I'm going to. Okay, go ahead.
I thought I said 300, didn't I?
Yes, you did. So I'm going to rephrase my comment. Everybody should change their bid.
Okay.
So let's start again.
$25, Bob.
Very good. Gavin for $25. Donnie McFarlane says $62. Joe, what are you thinking?
$40.
Okay. $100 and two high fives from Dan McClellan, but what do you think, Seb?
Let's go with $20.
$19.95.
Oh, come on. We all overbid.
All right, you know what? Here's a chance for you guys all to get back on the board because I feel that this is a good one and an easy one.
Wow.
Tippmann nice. Model 98 custom marker with XL barrel and a view loader hopper. Now, for those of you that are listening at home, this is a custom painted marker. It's a silver, original silver gun, but they put dye sticky grips on it, and they painted the raised letters with a green nail polish and put a matching green anodized
expansion chamber.
Yes, because expansion chamber, that'll drop.
A double trigger.
And then it has a drop forward that has like a half flame.
That grips from a DM4, too, if I'm not mistaken.
No,
that's prior. That's a 45 degree. So that's from an autococker or anything like that.
Autococker.
So what are you guys thinking? Let's get you guys back on the board. I will say the hopper has a little bit of black tape on it, as it should.
Joe's up to bat here.
You know what? Let's look here. We got Tracy Burns. Hi, Tracy. Says $175. But then Blake's the man says $22. Dave Dinda says ugly. Barney Hulk Doc, nice to see you, sir, says, Jesus, that's $80 all day.
All day,
every day. I will only say go easy on your pocketbooks. Just because it's custom, it doesn't fit into that criteria this time. Who needs to go first?
Joe's still
all right.
Leading off here.
$80.
Seb, let's let Gavin go last on the phone.
I'm waiting for my main man, Brent, to answer that for me right now. I just reached out to him in the chat form. So
how does he feel?
He's more than likely getting a beer or something. I don't know. He's not answering.
All right. Thomas says $75. What does Gavin say?
$50.
$50. Same with Jason Bryant says $50. What are you thinking, Seb?
Let's go with $85.
$85. Shizzle Manizzle says $82.
Hey.
Would anybody like to change their bid?
Uh-oh.
This sold for $29.99.
What?
It's eBay. Nothing goes for much money on eBay. Do we have a... How are we for scores? Because I would like to end this.
Seven is winning. Sev has two, and Gavin and I each have one, so we can call it a game.
Let's call it a game. We'll concede to Gavin on that
one. It's garbage night.
Actually, it is. It's garbage and recycling night tonight.
It is.
It was just this in honor of Zubricus.
Zootalore.
This one's
indeed.
For you, buddy.
Zootalore, indeed.
And Matt Decrypt, because he's just so lovely and talented.
All right. What we're going to do here, guys, we're going to end the show. If someone happens to call in one more time, we'll take one more, but then we're going to call it the day.
They speak Spanish to you.
We're going
to
see. Who's this on the line? Are you going to clear your throat and hang up, or are you the pizza guy?
Oh, it's the prank call again. You can hang up. That's from Prank Hal. I know this because I've used this.
Yeah, you seem to have experience with that program.
Very good. All right, guys, thank you very much for listening. Thank you for watching. Sorry we didn't have a lot of content this week because we had a busy weekend doing a lot of broadcasting for the Ontario Paintball League. Gavin Sharma, thank you for coming in the show. Thank you for participating and trying your best at The Price is Right.
I'm a weekly loser, my friends, and so are you for watching the show. But make sure you like and share.
Go watch
somebody else will be losers, too.
Very good. Joe Kimson from Flaggarters Paintball.
Thanks, everyone, for tuning in on Monday night to Behind the Bunker Live, a live weekly paintball TV show where we talk about all things and several things all paintball-y.
For sure. And Josh Zubizutilor Zubrickis, unfortunately, could not make it in tonight. But Seb, with half his shirt, showed up.
Thanks for watching, and bless your heart, and yes, good evening.
Very good. And Matt the Crit for pushing buttons.
I'm alive.
And not being on camera tonight. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. Make sure you go, guys, head on over to iTunes, Podomatic, Stitcher, SoundCloud, wherever you guys get your better podcasts, and find Behind the Bunker, download us, and have a listen while you're at work or school or wherever, traveling, wherever you listen to your better podcasts. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next week.